Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be walking through a little bit about the solar electronics test equipment designed for MIL Standard 461, CS115, and CS116 testing. We're going to focus heavily on the associated test accessories that solar offers and that we rent as an accessory kit. If you're interested in additional information on the transient generators, there's a lot of information out there, and you can of course reference the Solar Electronics website. During the video, we're going to focus more heavily on MIL Standard 461 CS116, given some of the same equipment can be used for CS115 testing. Keep in mind, as we're walking through, this isn't all the equipment needed to perform these tests, but some of the most commonly used solar equipment. During the video today, you will also notice that we're not including any listens, cabling, analyzers, or other equipment that might be commonly available in a testing environment. Let's go ahead and let's start to walk through some of the equipment. Starting on the left, you'll see the Solar 9355-1 transient generator for MIL Standard 461 CS115. And just to the right of that, you'll see our Solar 9354-2 designed for CS116 as well as RTCA DO160 section 22. Just to the right of that, you will notice our CS115 and CS116 accessory package. This package includes two injection devices and the associated calibration fixtures, one current monitoring probe, and two attenuators as well as a termination load. Now let's go ahead and let's take a little closer look at the accessories. Here you'll find some of the Solar Electronics MIL Standard 461, CS115, and CS116 test accessories. I'll go ahead and I'll put a link in the description below that'll take you to the Solar Electronics webpage that'll allow you to reference each individual accessory by the associated standard. Starting from our left, you will see the Solar 9335-2 coupling clamp and the associated fixture which it's placed in. Just to the right of that, you will see the Solar 9841-1 50 ohm termination load. Now working our way right, you will see two solar attenuators, the first of which the Solar 9410-1 and the second the Solar 9454-1. Just to the right of that, you will see the Solar 9123-1N current monitoring probe, and finally our second injection device, the Solar 9142-1N and the associated calibration fixture. Here you're going to find the Solar 9335-2 clamp, which can be used for 10 kHz, 100 kHz, and 1 MHz frequency ranges. This clamp is capable of conducting tests both for MIL Standard 461 CS116 as well as RTCA DO160 section 22. Now this clamp opens up right here from the front locking mechanism, just like that. The latch opens up, and then let's go ahead and let's put it in our associated calibration fixture. So to do that, all you have to do is remove the top of the fixture just like that, open up the clamp, put it underneath there, around the calibration fixture, and then close it and lock it back up. And we'll go ahead, we'll put the top on that fixture as well. That's how you would insert the clamp inside of the calibration fixture. Now let's go ahead and let's take a little closer look at the fixture itself. On the front side of the fixture, you will notice four different ports. Starting in the lower right-hand corner, you will notice port 1, port 2, and then just above port 2, port 3, and then finally, you'll see port 4. For testing to MIL Standard 461, we are going to be using port 2 on our 9335-2 clamp. Okay, so taking a look on both the left and the right of our Solar 9335-2, you will see on the right side we do have our 50 ohm termination load, and then on the left side we have our high voltage attenuator, and that's going to be the Solar 9410-1. And the connection from that attenuator is going to be going to your oscilloscope, and that's going to be used during the verification process. All right, so now let's go ahead. Let's take a brief look at the Solar 9142-1N. Taking a look in front of us right here, we have the Solar 9142-1N injection probe, and we have it placed right now in the Solar 9125-1 calibration fixture. And this probe can be used for 10 megahertz, 30 megahertz, and 100 megahertz frequency ranges for MIL-STD-461. Taking a look in front of us, you can see we did already place our injection probe inside of the associated calibration fixture. On the right of the fixture, you will see our 50 ohm termination load, and then on the left side, our high voltage attenuator, and that's going to go to our oscilloscope. So the two setups, both with the 9142-1 as well as the 9335-2, the setups are very similar, where you have a 50 ohm termination load on one side, and then you have your high voltage attenuator on the other. We appreciate everyone taking the time to walk through some of the different solar electronics test equipment that is commonly used for MIL-STD-461, CS115, and CS116 testing. During today's video, we walk through a little bit about the commonly used accessories. That's going to include injection probes, monitoring probes, and attenuators. Please keep us in mind if you're ever in need of any rental MIL-STD-461 conducted susceptibility test equipment. Thank you.